So to recap, yesterday, and I just posted, you know, we were talking about Game 7, Denver Nuggets, L.A. Clippers. The three of us, me, Lou, Jarrett, and Rel, who's not with us today, all picked the Clippers to win. Ben came through with the one underdog pick. And again, we weren't like, you know, all right, you know, we didn't shrug it off like, you're crazy. No.
Right, right.
Just like, I don't see it, but it could happen. And then it happened. But I mean, I'll speak first on this and just say I was surprised in the fashion that it happened. I expected more from the Clippers, and if it was my team, I would say they let me down. You know, I just expected better, and I wanted to see a more entertaining Game 7. You know, as much as we hype up Game 7s, this is it, do or die, win or go home, da-da-da, and they was just like, we're going to lose.
Yeah, they really quit at the end.
Like, they quit, and it was terrible.
Like, third quarter, they just dropped the ball, man. Like, yeah. I was watching the game. I was like, all right, you know, the fourth quarter is close. I'm expecting something to happen from the Clippers. Like, somebody take over the game. But, man, Paul George couldn't find the basket hoop. It was the size of a swimming pool.
He did find a backboard, though.
He found the backboard plenty.
He backboard, yeah.
That corner he was like three. For 100. He wide that open, three was, corner yeah. three. And he just was like, oh, make it rain.
I mean, I wasn't surprised. Like, I've never seen him do anything good in the playoffs. Like,
I mean, we was just saying, what, two games ago, the game ago, he had 30-something. Like, if he could do that, if he could just give us 30, then
Kawhi. He has moments, but he's not consistent.
And that's the problem. And that's the problem. And surprisingly, even Kawhi didn't even –
But you know what does bother me is just take your L, they beat you. Now they're like, oh, well, we weren't thinking about winning the championship this year. Really?
Yeah. But nobody said it was win or bust this year. Yes, nah, we all said that.
Yeah, y'all did.
That much talent? Yeah, nah, y'all should be thinking about that.
Y'all built the team. They built that team for the Lakers.
For the Lakers.
For the playoffs. For the playoffs.
Everybody. Yeah. For the Lakers.
Yeah.
So, that team was built on – okay, we got, you know, Lou Will off the bench. We got Bev to play defense. We got the enforcer and Martell Harris, like, heartless, but, like, they fucking fell apart.
And they even signed Joakim Noah, who didn't play, but he fits that mold. So even if he's yelling off the bench or whatever, he's still that type of, you know, mentality. So their mentality was defense first. And for some reason, they kept double-teaming. I'm like, you got guys that are the best on-ball defenders
in the world.
Every position, and y'all doubling and getting beat on it. When do you say, hey, let's stop doubling?
Right. I mean, and Joker made them look like fools.
Yes.
In that late third quarter to the fourth. Like, he was like, all right, come with the double.
Everyone knows he wants to pass anyway.
Right.
He's
a big man that can pass.
And 10 rebounds. He's cool with that. He's not looking to drop 30. He wants to pass. So you're doubling him. He's like – and he's good. His head is on a swivel. He's – thank you. Like, wherever the double comes from, he looks that way. Like, it's – and then they swing it around. Like, dude, I'm editing while it's on. So every time I look up, it looked like it was deja vu. They were doing the same thing over and over again.
Same thing.
Yeah.
And then you get the Clippers come down court and play one-on-one ISO.
Yeah. Like,
what are y'all doing? They're getting beat.
Yeah. So, like I said, not to take anything away, Ben, you picked them.
Yes, sir.
You was right. You know what I mean?
Once in a while.
Once in a while. You know, you got it right. We were all, like I said, not to downplay it, but none of it. We all was just like, yeah, you know, it could happen. They was on a rhythm.
I just thought they had the momentum going for themselves. They had their confidence is very high, and they're all young guys. I mean,
right. And they had nothing
to happen.
And it felt like, and this is the difference because, like we said, Kawhi might be more talented than Jimmy Butler, but Jimmy Butler is a better leader.
Yeah, he'll lead his team. He'll push his team more because Kawhi doesn't do it. He doesn't talk.
And he's gonna Kawhi doesn't talk. His he had some facial expressions yesterday. You could read his face and see what he wanted to say, but he don't say it. And I think that's what they were missing. Because again, going back to what we were saying in the last episode, you know, Kyle Lowry and them stepped up. Lowry is vocal.
Yeah.
And, you know, so even if Kawhi was on court leading them, Lowry was a good leader in the huddles and, you know, a floor general and things like that. And Kawhi's going to do what Kawhi do.
Yeah.
They were lacking that because Paul George is a Robin, as they like to use the Batman Robin analogy. Paul George is a Robin, and he
– nigga Nightwing.
Like a
Joker. Oh, shit.
I think I saw it somewhere on Twitter. It's like Paul George's best highlights are in the Gatorade commercial.
No, somebody had a video of him dribbling, and it was like Paul George highlights, and he's just dribbling, and then it said, "Thank you for watching."
So yeah, it's like the Gatorade commercial. I was like, "Yeah," because he's like, "What? He made the shot." And he's like, "All day, all day," or something. Oh, I forget what
that was. One good stint with the Pacers. He had a good second half of a season, and he was really hyped up from then. And, you know, obviously came back from a leg injury and all that good stuff, but he's never really shown to be the man to, you know, so that, yeah. And so as we also said, if the Clippers lose, this hits a lot of legacies. Doc's legacy, Kawhi's legacy.
Yeah, because it was third time, right? Third
and to take it a step further.
So, yeah.
The associate coaches on the bench. You got Sam Cassell. Yeah. You got Tyronn Lue. Right. All of them are supposed to be the next, you know, next NBA coaches. Well, I don't know what's going to happen now when you might not get that interview.
Right. You know, unless you throw people under the bus like, well, he ain't let me talk.
and to go back on that Raptors team, though, last year, they had Kawhi. They had Kyle Lowry. They had Marc Gasol. They had Siakam have his come out, you know, series. So – that team was much better built than the Clippers team was.
Ibaka was happy. He was content with taking a lesser role.
Right.
You know, he's been defensive player of the year. He's got awards, and you didn't hear him complain about being a lesser, you know, player in the
Fred VanVleet had his playoff season, you know, series debut come out of there. So that team was, I think, better constructed for what Kawhi wanted to do.
Yeah.
Hindsight is 20/20.
You're right.
You know, the Raptors did get bounced, but I think the Raptors got bounced by a much better team and a hotter team going into it. But Clippers, man,
and we don't forget the Raptors beat Philly on that three bounce shot that Kawhi made. So that could have went either way. Same way we kind of forgot that they was up 2-1 on Denver when that fingertip block that Kawhi got. So if that shot goes in, that could have changed the, you know, the dynamic of the series. So a lot of it is one plays here and there. So that's what I said. Now we start to look at Kawhi's legacy a little bit more. Like, is he really is, you know, and I want to ask Jared, we had this conversation, I guess, was it earlier this year, last year, talking about you had Kawhi in your top five since like the last, what, seven years, something like that? It's been a while. You had him up there
for a while, yeah. But that was, I mean, but shit.
What happened was,
but you know, he showed when he's the top dog, and I mean, he was the top dog last year. So let's not forget that. But getting out the East, you know, all right, that's an accomplishment because it could have been. It could have been Philadelphia. It could have been Milwaukee. Yeah. Or it could have been Boston. But so that was cool getting to the finals. It was very fortunate that KD and Klay both were injured. So he got fortunate in that. So that kind of, you know, that's you can say that takes away from, you know, it can take away from the moment a little bit, but
that's right. I didn't even get to the finals. Yeah, their championship now definitely looked tainted.
it can take away from that, but at the same time, you know, whether you full strength or not, you took advantage of the moment and you shine, you know, when it mattered. Mm-hmm. So he got looked at even better as like the man. But, you know, this year you went against I didn't even think Denver should have even got past Utah. Like, this is the first time I've ever seen back-to-back 3-1, you know, over, you know, like overcoming.
Well, that's 3-1. First time ever.
Yeah, that's happened. It's amazing to see that happen. So, I mean, hats off to Denver. I was definitely salty about Denver because they kind of cost me on a bet before, during the bubble. But I mean, look, I mean, I knew it was a really good team. I knew it was a complete team. Getting Gary Harris back was definitely an upside. Jeremiah Grant, you know, he's been popping threes. You know, like he's real athletic, so he's been doing this. He's been doing this thing. So it's great to see, you know, the story of Denver, because it's not the highly touted team. You know, you have Jokic and Murray, which are nice stars. And don't get me wrong, Jamal Murray is probably may have just eclipsed himself to a superstar status, at least in this playoffs alone. But the fact that you're overcoming Donovan Mitchell and Gobert, people were thinking, I mean, even though Denver was a three, they were, especially when they were down 3-1, people were like, oh, you know, it's Donovan Mitchell, Gobert. They got Conley. So, you know, now they got Conley back. You know, Utah's probably primed to go a little bit further. Mm-hmm. Now you have against the Clippers, the team that everybody thinks is going to be the contender to the Lakers. Mm-hmm. And they're just showing that it's about that. It's about their heart. Like Mike Malone, he's had some questionable things, you know, but about his coaching, but his team has responded. And that just shows the heart of that team. You can't count Denver out, and I respect that.
Yeah. I mean, we doubted them twice, and they pulled through two game sevens back to back. They actually get 2 days off until the next game, so they get a little bit of a break because, you know, I was asking, I'm like, how much energy does Murray have left in him? And instead, it was the Clippers that was burnt. They said they was fatigued. You know, again, all these excuses come out now. Yeah, right. When it's after the fact, I don't want to hear it. Like, right, game seven, you want to step up for.
That's not say, but my thing is, you can't say fatigued if you're not traveling anywhere.
You're not going nowhere.
You're not going nowhere.
You're going to sleep. Like, you are home. Every game is in your backyard. Like, y'all right. Playing right there.
Like, what are you doing? That's fatiguing you. Like, you're not having the long practice. You're not having travel days. Like,
yeah, no flight nowhere. Yeah. Everything is casual. They're not even stressing them to dress up and all that. They not. You don't see them really. You see a couple of guys, but right. You don't see them to walk into the arena with they suits and all
yeah,
that.
Yeah, there's no press. Like, yeah. Ain't any press tours. Like, ain't nothing to be tired about. This is the freshest you're going to be in your entire career.
This was the opportunity to perfect. And you just had 6 months off.
Right.
Like, so now from, what, July to September, you tired?
And you can't say you're tired when Jamal Murray was freaking dropping 50 and damn near 60 a freaking game.
Right.
Just to survive. Yeah. Like, just to survive the playoffs.
I thought he would be burnt out. He stepped up again. Yeah. This was the second quarter when they were down. He's the one that brought them back. He mm-hmm. stepped up. Like, he's earning respect. He's making a name for himself for those that didn't know him. He's earning respect across the league.
A star.
Yeah, I just thought
Eric gonna say he knew he was the top five for the last 5, 6, 7 years. So yeah, he
definitely this year, but I don't know about the last.
Well,
know,
the good thing is we recording this stuff now. So now when we make bold predictions, you know, we can always refer back to the footage.
Yes, we should.
Or as Cardi B said, the footages.
The footages. The footages.
So my presentation to you guys was to spin off a new segment, you know, the name pending, you know, a betting type of thing. Because Jared, you know, again, not to throw you under the bus, but you like to observe the gambling, the lines. You know, you may partake.
I like to dabble in things.
Dabble,
yeah.
Dabble.
But you do
in the finesses.
You do watch the gambling lines and you know where they go, and. Mm-hmm. So I wanted you guys to, you know, and you know, we're all opinionated.
Yeah.
You know, Lou is good with the stats and things like that. Lou is always on point with the stats. And Ben just makes the bold predictions and then sometimes, you know, backtracks on them. But
I don't know about that, bro. I haven't backtracked on none.
So
I didn't think they were going to lose.
So I presented you guys with an idea to, you know, have your own thing to, you know, come up with a pick'em kind of show, or you know, like again, title pending. We'll figure out a name for it later, whatever. You know, we can call it pick'em. I don't care. Pick of the week, pal.
Something like that. Copyrights with all those.
We'll see what we can do. We'll see what we can do. Yeah, we'll spell it differently. Yeah.
Like I bet.
Yeah, spell it with a, you know, spell
we'll,
it with
we'll figure it out. Let's just see how it goes, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But for the next, I mean, to before we go to like the week of betting and all that stuff or whatever, I mean, we now have the Final Four. We saw the Miami and Boston game one.
Talk about one play there.
Right. I mean, that game went to overtime. Right. Which was kind of some BS. They had a little BS call at the end that gave Boston the free throw to tie it up, which, you know, whatever. But what do y'all think about that series first? We'll go with that series first. You know, it's one zip now, but do y'all see Miami holding on and winning that series, or do you see Boston coming out on that one? Whoever take it first.
I said Miami 4-3 on the last homie call.
You did.
I'm standing by that.
So you got Miami in 7.
I'm taking Miami in 6.
Okay.
I just think that bully ball, that Jimmy Butler ball, I'm calling it, is I don't think something the Celtics – I mean, the Celtics have been in the playoffs before, but this is not the same Celtics team. You know, there's no Kyrie on this team. There's no Al Horford on this team. There's a bunch of young guys that haven't done it yet, haven't proven themselves. As much as Jason Tatum's – I don't think Jason Tatum has taken that next step. We've seen Jamal Murray take that next step. You know, we've seen Fred VanVleet and Siakam take it last year in the playoffs. Like,
but we also seen those guys step out of the bubble.
Right. Yeah.
because of Tatum and Brown.
Yeah. Minus Jamal Murray, who's still in there.
Right.
But I don't think Tatum has supplanted himself as a superstar of that team yet. You know, it's been still defaulted as Kimba's team, and Kimba really hasn't done anything in the playoffs when he was with the Hornets. So I'm taking Miami in 6.
Okay, so we got Miami in 6, we got Miami in 7, and Ben, the one we've been waiting for.
I've been leaning towards Miami myself. Okay. I'm gonna go with 6.
I was gonna say I got Boston in 5.
Okay,
Miami in 6. I'm
the oddball here. I think Boston's gonna win. I still got Boston coming out in 7.
I think a lot's gonna depend on the next game, like how Boston reacts to this loss.
Yeah.
That's going to tell you a lot, I feel. But the way Miami's playing.
Boston kept going up big and then couldn't hold on to the lead. And that's the biggest issue with a lot of the younger teams. Right. They don't know how to hold leads.
They lose their confidence, too. So Miami, high confidence.
Yeah.
Denver, high confidence. Young team. I think it helps them a lot. But when they start losing, they're like, oh, wait, we let that slip. Oh, wait, we let that slip. That's why I felt the Clippers were going to lose. And that's why Boston, I think it's going to be a tough matchup, though. Don't get me wrong. I think it's going to be tough. But I think they're going to be – Miami is going to be a little bit more gritty, just going to get it out there. I think they're going to win that. Close games.
Right, and you got to remember, they're in the bubble. So these teams, these confidence teams, don't have to deal with opposing teams' crowds – and being drowned out. And
there's no home court advantage.
There's no home court advantage anymore.
And stuff on screen.
Right. So, like, you know.
But
like,
you don't see them.
You got Denver playing L.A. It's not going to have the same feeling of playing L.A. in L.A.
Right.
You know, when the crowd is jumping down your throat.
Same thing, like Miami and Boston, because everybody was talking about the Boston Garden and playing in there and how those fans are. So, yeah, that element is gone.
They definitely lose that.
Mm-hmm. Outside of COVID, Denver would just spend like a month in LA playing basketball.
Crazy.
So
that could also be a distraction because you spending nights in LA,
right? For an entire month. So these confidence teams are really, really benefiting from the bubble.
So speaking of confidence, speaking of LA, Denver's confidence now goes to LA's confidence. Some people are saying LA taking Denver for granted, might sleep on them. So we'll see what that is. You know, like I said, I think that series don't start till Friday. So who y'all got in that one?
That one's tough for me. I like to see at least one game in. I got to see them play. I got to see them play so I can feel it out. But
so my deciding factor is going to be the point guard play. The Lakers struggled with point guard play. Chris Paul, you know, was doing his thing for a minute. If Jamal Murray goes off this series, that's really – I don't think anyone they can put on to defend him outside of LeBron, if he wants to go that far. So, if LeBron Jamal Murray dominates the way he's been –
LeBron not defending nobody.
Oh, yeah, we know that. I'm just, you know,
He'll do it for one play, and they'll
one play, and they'll be like,
the best player on the other team.
Yeah, switch. So it's going to come down to point guard play. I think everyone wants to see LA go because it's LA. I would love to see Denver in seven. That's my dream, to see Denver in seven. Will it happen?
3-1 again?
Nah, they can't come back from 3-1 against the Lakers. LeBron ain't letting that shit happen against him.
I mean, it's not like LeBron hasn't had falters like that, but.
Right.
All right, Jared, what you got?
I want to say Denver in seven. But honestly, it really depends on the Lakers role players, because you know LeBron and AD are gonna, you know, like AD can like, he can body with Jokic, so he can switch, you know, off that matchup. Who's the starting center again? McGee, so you can.
But he don't play that much. He's like,
yeah. So I mean, so you can either have McGee or Howard can he can size up with Jokic, but you have AD, you know, face up against Jokic, and then maybe Millsap would probably be guarded by like McGee or whoever is Lakers five. But I don't see anybody really stopping Murray in terms of the Lakers backcourt. LeBron is going to guard against Michael Porter and abuse him.
Yeah, he is.
But that's LeBron. You know, I mean, not many people really are successful guarding him one on one like that, except Kawhi, who's now bounced. But you know, it's gonna be an interesting matchup. Can Rajon Rondo still hit threes? Like, that's I can't see that really going.
Nah, I can't see that.
But at the same time, Paul did say the law averages, and that's why he thought, you know, like the Clippers are going to win. That didn't happen. So who knows how far the averages are going to go? But I definitely don't see it in six. If anything, it'll be a seven game series. Could they going to give it all? I would love to see Denver or Miami. So I was going to say, fuck it, Denver, Miami.
I like that.
You got Denver in six, you said?
No, seven.
Seven.
Oh, seven. So, and Ben, Lou, you said LA.
Denver seven.
You said seven. Okay, so okay.
Yeah, I didn't really make the pick yet, but okay. I'm gonna make the pick just because you guys want one now.
Right.
I'm gonna lean Lakers next.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm not a fan particularly of the Lakers, but they have LeBron. It's gonna keep them calm and composed when Denver goes on their runs.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be a tough series, but I think because they had so many 3-1 games to overcome, they eventually got to come down.
I thought that would be last night.
Well, now I think it might happen with this one.
Yeah.
It's just – it's going to be tough for them, you know, they to get that energy again. And, I mean, they were spent. I mean, the Lakers are a little bit more rested right now. So, I'm just going to lean towards the Lakers, just towards the experience right now on this one, and we'll see where that one goes. But probably – Lakers in six.
I got Lakers in five. I think they're going to wash them. I think Denver ran their course. They had a good run. Lakers in five. I think the game one is going to tell all, because we've seen how lightly L.A. takes game ones. Mm-hmm. And I think if L.A. comes out, like, right out the gate in game one, it's going to be five. If they take them easy, then it might go six or something. But I still see Lakers winning the series. So, but I'm saying right now, Lakers in five. So I'm gonna go with that, because I think they're gonna just step up and just bring them down, because Denver's too hype right now. And you know, LeBron don't like to be not talked about. You know, it's like this is my show. It's my bubble.
They're on a high, and like, they're gonna run into the Lakers, which is best right now, and they're gonna go for a run, and now then that's where they're going to have to overcome, and I don't think they're going to be able to do it right now. They're just going to be exhausted.
So it's all on the books. We got the picks. We're going to see what happened. Again, all in all, we had some good games, but the bubble has been, you know, sporadic. It's been up, it's been down. It's been a lot of jump shots. It's been funny moments.
A lot of funny moments.
We're down to the final four. I just want good games. You know, if anything, I just want to see good games. Like, that game seven was a big letdown. You know, again, not because they were my team, but just because it wasn't entertaining. Yeah. It wasn't entertaining to watch. Like, you hype up game seven. You know, we record and we like, all right, we got to get home. We got to, you know, eat something, get some, you know, get just to get ready to watch that. And it was just like,
what I do. 3 minutes into the third, it was over.
It was over.
It was over. Yeah, it was over.
It was over. Like, no comeback, no run made. Like, it was a wrap. They were down. When they were down by 20, I was like, yo, this is
when they went down by 20, Stephen A got an Instagram. We're like, it's over. It's over.
It was pitiful. Like, it was sad to even watch. Like, dude, just stop it. Like, just go away. Like, y'all don't belong here. You look bad. Right. Like, it was like, couldn't do Stephen nothing.
Wait, did Stephen A did his like that?
I hate it when he does that.
He was so shocked.
I saw a video of him do like a head palm. I saw that.
I remember last year when he did that, like, he had like his hand gesture was like, mm-hmm.
He should never do that again. I hope he never does that again.
That's funny.
All right, well, the picks is in, like I said, we'll see what happens. All right. To be continued, the conversation continues.